Hello everyone, we are students from Pondicherry Engineering College. I am Arunraj. Now I will take you through our project. Our project is web-based remote monitoring and control of irrigation process. First of all, we will see the block diagram. So this is the block diagram of our project. We are using four sensors, namely temperature sensor, soil moisture sensor, light intensity and fertility sensor. These are the sensors that we are using, and the data or values from these sensors are properly signal conditioned and then given to the next stage, which is the ADC. This ADC will convert the analog values of the sensors collected and convert it into a digital data to the microcontroller. The microcontroller will in turn transfer the data received from the sensor to the server PC. The communication that is used is serial communication, that is the PC interface shown here. So on the whole, this is a data acquisition system that collects the data from all these sensors to the server PC. Now we are taking it furthermore by using a web. This web will enable us to access the data collected in server PC via any PC from any part of the world. So that is client PC. Now we are making this full entire system a closed loop by using a water pump. The purpose of using a water pump is when the process variable is lesser than the set point value, the water pump will be activated. When the process variable is greater than the set point value, the water pump will be switched off. So making this entire system a closed loop system. Now we will see the hardware part. So this is the sensors, hardware of the sensors. This is the soil moisture part. This is the phototransistor. So the phototransistor is used as the light intensity sensor. And this is the fertility sensor. The electrodes that are used for fertility sensor are these two. And the electrodes that are used for soil moisture are these two electrodes. So the values from these sensors are taken to the ADC, and this is the ADC. Here this ADC will convert the analog values received from the sensors into digital data and further transfer it to the microcontroller. This is the microcontroller. The microcontroller will in turn transfer the data to the server PC via serial communication. Here we are using MAX232. MAX232 is used for serial communication. And the data are then taken to the server PC. Here this acts as the server PC. This is the front panel of our project. This is the LabVIEW file. So these are the different charts for each sensor. This chart is for soil moisture. This chart is for temperature sensor. These two sensors are for light intensity and fertility sensor respectively. Now I'll show you the block diagram. So this is the block diagram of our project. This is the main loop that is used to acquire the data, and this is the COM one that is used for serial, and VESA serial is also used. All the data are received and read from via this VESA read. And here this block diagram will be executed when soil moisture is used, fertility or temperature or light intensity. And this block diagram executes various other events when the process variable is either less than the set point or greater than the set point, ultimately running the motor. So now we will see the real process. This is the web part which we are going to use for accessing the data in the server PC. We can see this web page via in the server PC from any client PC, and any user will be able to see these pictures from any part of the world. This is the block diagram, and this is the circuit diagram of our project, circuit diagram of each sensors, and other features of our project. This link is used to click the main project VI. Now we will see the real-time process. Now we will see the working from model of our project. we have set the hardware accordingly. So now I'll show you the sensors that is set accordingly. Now these are the sensors that is inserted into our box. Our main purpose is the soil moisture sensor. So we are monitoring the only the values collected from the soil moisture sensor. This is the soil moisture sensor. Accordingly, the soil moisture electrodes are inserted into a box. Here you can see the two electrodes that is inserted into the box. Inside this box there is sand, and this sand is in dry condition. If you come over here, you can see the dry sand. These are the dry sands, and now the sand is in dry condition. And so we can say that the data collected from the soil moisture sensor are in dry condition. So now if you come to the lab view, you can see the front panel. This is the soil moisture chart. Here we are monitoring only the soil moisture values, sensor value obtained. Now if we can see the block diagram as well. If we put the bulb and see the process, we can identify the running values. These are the data that are being collected. We'll insert two probes over here. These are the two probes. So the data that is collected at present is the light intensity, so which we can read in the buffer. Accordingly, the values are collected and displayed in the chart. Now soil moisture value is being collected. The value is 228, and accordingly it is being plotted in the chart. So at every instance, the data are being collected and displayed in the chart. So this is the these are the values that are displayed, collected and displayed in the chart at various intervals of time. Now now we'll see the data that are collected when the soil is in wet condition. Now we are pouring water into this box. When we pour water, the condition will become wet. So we are going to collect the data when the soil moisture is in wet condition. Now the water has been poured here. Now we can see the box is fully immersed in water. So this is the wet condition. The sensors, the data collected from the sensor are recorded in the lab view, and they are the data in wet condition. So accordingly, if we see the value, the chart in the front panel of the lab view, we can see that values have changed from the previous value. The red line which you see here is the process variable, that is the values at present value. And the white line here you can see is the set point. When we vary the set point down, we can see that the value is changed. So the white line value that shows is corresponding to the set point. And the red line is the process variable value, that is the soil moisture value. And secondly, we have also made our system a closed loop system. That is, when the process variable is greater than the set point, the motor is turned off. That is, we are using a water pump to pour. Here we are manually pouring water, but in real time agricultural process, water pump is used to activate and deactivate the motor. When we activate the motor, it will turn the water on, and accordingly the soil moisture value will be either collecting data whether in dry condition or wet condition. If we vary the set point greater than the, if we vary it more than vary it near 200, we can see that it has increased above the process variable. This white line represents the set point, and red line represents the process variable. Accordingly, the motor has turned on.
So we have made this system a closed loop system. Now we will see the block diagram as well. When in the wet condition, if we put the bulb, we can see the process that is running here. So here the process is running. The data from say VESA is being received. And if we put the two blocks, you can see the fertility sensor value is being collected at the same, and its value is registered. And accordingly, the data are being plotted in the chart. This block, this full loop executes that functioning of displaying it to the chart. Now temperature sensor value is being collected at present, and its data is being displayed in the chart accordingly. So all this functioning is done inside this loop. This is the main part of our